Carotid artery stenosis increases your risk for stroke. Please welcome Dr. Gregg Silverman joining us right now. You know a lot about this, being the doctor that you are.
I do this for a living. Not completely for a living, but this is part of what I do for a living. Yes.
Okay, so exactly, it's an artery that goes up in the neck, is that correct?
Correct. There's two of them. There's one on the left and one on the right. And as they get stenotic, the higher the stenosis, which is a blockage, the higher likelihood you have for a stroke or a TIA, which is a stroke, but it lasts less than 24 hours. That is, it kind of resolves on its own.
And so how would you know that you're experiencing any issues? Is it like mini strokes that are happening?
Maybe even mini strokes, or sometimes even having had a stroke. That is weakness on one side of your body, where when one part of your face droops and doesn't go, as opposed to the other side. Sometimes visual disturbances can cause these. But most of the time, people don't know that they have it. And most of the time, it's caught on either a physical exam or something that people do. Sometimes people get these things from their churches and they get a carotid artery ultrasound, and that can see stenosis as well.
Is there a long-term problem if it goes undiagnosed for, say, a couple months, if you haven't been to your doctor in a while?
Well, I don't know if it's a couple months, but over years, the answer is yes. That is, over years, your likelihood of having strokes increases significantly as the stenosis goes up.
With the new guidelines for blood pressure and things like that, is it better? You catch this quicker?
I think a lot of times people get good physical exams. I think a lot of times people get to their physicians or their healthcare providers in time. They listen to the carotid arteries. If you hear a brewery or flow murmur there, it's a murmur across the carotids, it is likely that those things are stenotic or those things have some narrowing. At that point, you would be sent to have some imaging studies, either an ultrasound, generally an ultrasound first, or a CAT scan or an MRI to see, is there a significant stenosis there?
Really quickly, treatments for those blood thinners?
Well, no. Well, generally it's either surgery where you can remove the plaque, or angioplasty. Now we put stents in the carotid arteries. There's several different ways of doing this.
Dr. Silverman, you're the man. We appreciate it.
Well, thank you.
Thank you for coming in.